In most industrial settings, you do not have just one or two motors to control. You have many motors, sensors, and control circuits to look for. Therefore, it is impossible to have all of these wires just in your mind. No matter the language you speak, there's a universal way to explain and show the electrical setup inside any panel. We need global standards such as IEC or NEMA to depict panel wiring clearly, allowing anyone to understand it easily. That is just what an electrical wiring diagram can do. When approaching an electrical panel, safety precautions are crucial to prevent accidents and ensure your well-being. Stay safe and abide by safety rules and regulations. There are minor variations among electrical wiring diagrams due to factors such as software, company practices, units and symbols, and regional differences. Understanding these diagrams will equip you to work with any standard. All it takes is some time to become familiar with them. Let's start with the title block. The title block, always located at the bottom, provides crucial information about the drawing, such as the designer name, date, project name, system designation, revision details, and page. Understanding this section enables easy identification and referencing. Next up, pay close attention to the borderline and grid. These elements help maintain consistency and organization throughout the drawing. Regardless of whether it's a vertical or horizontal grid, a structured layout makes it easier to locate information quickly and accurately. Each wiring paper is divided into sections, and each section has its own number from 1 to 8, or from 0 to 9 depending on the drawing scale. We use these sections and number of pages to allocate the end and the beginning of wires. For instance, these lines with arrows represent the power distribution wires across the drawing, coming from page number 1, section 8, to page number 5, section 2. The end of these wires on page number 5 is at section 7, but they can also be found on page number 6, section 2. As we can see in this drawing, the wire L1, L2, and L3 is coming from page number 11, section 2, and is going to page number 12, section 2. Here we are on page number 12, section 2, and it is going further to page number 13, section 2. And this goes on throughout the rest of the pages, with different section numbers. Knowing how to interpret arrow or line symbols will guide you in understanding the logical flow of electricity and information within the control panel. The dashed line in this figure, as well as in all diagrams, indicates that this part of the drawing is outside the panel or the section is not within the panel. It is situated in the field. This distinction helps clarify the boundary between what's contained within the panel and what extends beyond it. As you can see here, the dashed lines with the arrow between these two devices is a widely recognized and used symbol in the electrical industry to indicate interlocking mechanisms in drawings. Understanding the principles behind interlocking mechanisms is necessary for maintaining a secure working environment and adhering to industry regulations. The numbers and letters often seen next to components and connections are labels that help to identify each specific part or connection across different sections of the drawing and within the electrical system. By referring to these labels or tags, you can easily locate and identify different parts or wires for proper troubleshooting in industrial setups. When working with complicated diagrams in electrical drawings, power, control, and instrumentation wirings are allocated to separate pages. Each of these pages serves a distinct purpose. The power page typically deals with electrical distribution and loads. The control page highlights operational logic and control circuits, while the instrumentation page emphasizes measurement and monitoring systems. By navigating through these specialized pages, you gain a comprehensive overview of the entire system architecture. Moving on is the legend page. This is usually found in the beginning pages. It is attached with every wiring diagram and is your key to describing every symbols and abbreviations in the entire drawings, as we can see in this figure. These symbols alongside their descriptions, allow everyone interprets the drawings in the same way, which is essential for accurate maintenance and troubleshooting. This page may also detail the standard conventions used in the drawings, such as line types for different kinds of electrical connections, or the representation of various electrical phases. By having a clear legend, it speeds up the process of locating components and understanding the electrical system's layout, which is particularly useful during urgent troubleshooting scenarios. This ends the part 1 of the various segments we have on this topic. Familiarize yourself with the title block, borderline, grid layouts, legend page, equipment tags, and interlock systems to elevate your skills to the next level in the industrial sector as a technician or an engineer. Today's content was created in response to a request from our comments section, so a big thank you to everyone for actively participating in our community. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, and share. Please leave your questions, comments, and suggestions down below. And as always, click the bell icon to receive notifications and stay updated.